Hey guys, it's Holly and welcome on back to Stonehearth. Now our little city is coming along nicely, but we definitely need to still get some more buildings in there. Recently I noticed that the farmer and the cook actually work together to be able to maintain the crops. So I thought that was quite interesting. So what we are going to be doing today is we are actually going to be building a house that both the farmer and the cook can live in one, but I wanna make this a bit more like a house. So I wanna have a dining room, maybe a little kitchen, couple little bedrooms, stuff like that. I think this is gonna be pretty fun. Now, if you guys aren't actually playing Stonehearth, but you are playing another block-based game, you could actually use this as a bit of a blueprint, and you could actually put this house into one of those other games, which I thought is pretty cool, because you could still use the same measurements and everything like that. But that's probably enough babbling from me. Let's get this speed build underway.
Walking alone, the streets are empty. The only thing I can see is my own silhouette. I'm getting stronger, step by step. The clock is ticking, but there's no time for me. I've been flying from town to town, from London to Taiwan. I've been all around the globe trying to protect your soul.
And there we have it. That is our completed shared house, so our farmer and our cook will share this house. I'm really happy with the way it turned out. I like the fact that it has a little dining room, a little kitchen. We got a little seating area down there with a fireplace, sort of like a lounge room. And yeah, as always, guys, if you enjoyed this episode, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and also the like button if you did enjoy what you've seen. And I think I'm actually gonna have to leave this episode here today, guys. Thank you so much for joining me again, and I hope to see you all again soon. All right, thanks, guys. Bye.